Right, good morning all of you. Right, look at this problem. So a pair of spaghettis, a pair of spaghettis with involute teeth is to give a gear ratio of 4:1. The arc of approach is not to be less than the circular pitch. The arc of approach is not to be less than the circular pitch, and the smaller wheel is the driver. The angle of pressure is 14.5 degrees. Pressure angle is 14.5 degrees. Find the least number of teeth that can be used on each wheel. So that means the minimum number of teeth on pinion and minimum number of teeth on gear you need to calculate here, and the addendum of the wheel in terms of circular pitch. First you need to find out the addendum value, and you can express this in terms of circular pitch. Okay, so this figure is more important. You need to remember this figure. Spaghettis with involute teeth. So gear ratio is given. G is equal to 4. Right? Gear ratio is equal to number of teeth on gear divided by number of teeth on pinion. Right? That is equal to capital R by small r, because you can express mt divided by m into small t, right? Mm cancel, you will get t by t. Then the pressure angle is given, phi is equal to 14.5 degrees. Then the arc of approach is not to be less than the circular pitch value. Okay, so look at the board. So gear ratio is 4. That gear ratio you can express in terms of capital T by small t. And okay, so the radius means mt is nothing but the diameter of your gear, and small mt is the diameter of a pinion, right? So you can express like this, mm gets cancelled, so that you have capital R by small r. Then phi is the pressure angle. Kp is nothing but path of approach. It is equal to circular pitch. Okay, what is the maximum path of approach? Maximum path of approach is mp. Okay, instead of k you need to consider mp. That's equal to, in terms of pinion dimension, smaller, since the pinion is the value. Path of approach always calculated in terms of pinion dimensions. That small r sin phi is equal to pc, circular pitch. That is the condition given. Circular pitch you can express in terms of, circular pitch is equal to pi d by t. D by t is m. Okay, so small r sin phi is equal to pi into m. So phi is known value, m unknown parameter. So from this you will get the relation between r and m. Okay, so you are asked to find out the least number of teeth that can be used on both the wheels, right? So what is the formula to find out least number of teeth? Least number of teeth formula: length of arc of contact is equal to length of path of approach. Arc of approach is equal to divided by cos phi, is equal to small r sin phi divided by cos phi. That is equal to phi m, implies r tan phi is equal to phi m, implies small r into tan phi is equal to phi into d, r d by t, right? So phi into d can be expressed as 2 into r divided by t. Okay, so that r tan phi is equal to, right, r gets cancelled and implies like small t is equal to, small t is equal to tan phi divided by, sorry, reverse, 2 phi divided by tan phi, right? So from this you get the value of t. Okay, so in the same fashion you can find out the capital T value also. Okay, right? Then other parameter you are asked to find out the addendum value. Addendum of the wheel in terms of circular pitch. If you want to find out the addendum value, you need to find out capital RA value, or for addendum circle radius, small RA or capital RA. Once we have small RA or capital RA value, you can find out this value. Otherwise, we have the formula addendum of the pinion APM is equal to, we have formula MT by 2 into, what is the formula? MT by 2, right, this one, MT by 2 under root of 1 plus, if you use the capital T by T, right, into capital T by T plus 2 into sine square pi minus 1. So this equation you can use to find out addendum. Okay, so that's how you can calculate the value, right? So here you can find out number of teeth on pinion, similarly number of teeth on gear, right? So if you want addendum value, addendum coefficient into module, for this we already considered equation, right? AB into M is equal to MT by 2 into, right, this is under root 1 plus capital T by small t plus 2, right, into sine pi minus 1, or is T equal to G. Okay, right, you can find out the values. So clear?